I'm a car guy, okay? I like to drive. So how will I get along with the 2015 Ford Edge? It's packed to the brim with robot driving aids, and on a basic philosophical level, they sort of freak me out. The Ford Edge has lane keeping warnings. It can even perpendicular park all by itself. All this technology is geared towards keeping you out of trouble on that scary, scary open road. But does it help or hinder? That's what I aim to find out. Blind spot detection just plain makes good sense. So when a car enters your blind spot, an LED lights up on your side mirror, letting you know that a car is lurking in the adjacent lane. I think you actually need features like this for a car that's so big. Now, of course, it's no substitution for turning your head and checking, but every single bit of information can help you when you're driving. Now, I didn't find the system invasive at all, and in fact, it taught me a lot about exactly where my blind spots are located. So the lane keeping system is pretty straightforward. If you're driving more than 40 miles per hour and you start drifting over one of the lines, then you'll start seeing some warnings on the dashboard, and the steering wheel will try to nudge you back to where you're supposed to be. It's a very eerie feeling. It's borderline distracting, but it's not so distracting that it takes away from the driving experience. I still feel like I have control of the car. It's just a little nudge that's saying, hey, you're doing something wrong, buddy. Now, I'm surprised that there's no audible beep that lets you know you're in the wrong lane. Some people may not feel the steering wheel nudge them over, and they may not see the warnings on the dashboard. Now, of course, the system doesn't trigger if you're using your turn signals because the car thinks you want to go in the other lane. You can adjust the intensity of the system or turn it off entirely if you just don't want to deal with it. But given the number of dumbasses on the road Instagramming their cheeseburgers, I think this is the kind of thing that belongs in all cars. It looks like it's going to hit something. If I keep going, I'm going to hit that car. Okay, this is where you really turn over control to Ford's fancy pants driving robots. The car will identify appropriate spaces for both perpendicular parking and parallel parking. It will turn the wheel while you operate the gas and brake pedal. So I'm going to double press the parking assist. It's looking for a perpendicular space. It's scanning. Still looking. I just saw one. The car missed it. The thing I learned about the system is that it really wants to get into the space that it wants to get into. If you have an idea for a different space, you have to pull forward and turn the system on and off and sort of trick it to get it to go into the space that you want. Okay, here's another one. Let's see if it finds this one. Oh, hey, it found a spot. So it wants me to pull forward to get to a starting point. Now, you have to pull really far forward, and it's sort of an annoying part about the system. Sometimes you have to pull so far forward, you get the feeling, well, wait a second, someone's gonna slide into that spot that the car just identified. So I've stopped, gotta remove my hands from the wheel, I'm gonna shift it into reverse, lift my foot off the brake pedal to slide back in, no hands, and you find yourself going much more slowly than you ever would in a real parking situation because you don't trust the car to do what it's supposed to do. And it likes to cut really close. Sometimes you think you're gonna clip the car that's in the adjoining space, and you do have to trust it, but it does not inspire confidence. Most of the time, you do have to shift into forward and let the car adjust. The wheel's doing its thing, and now we're gonna go back into reverse. Mission accomplished. So throughout this whole perpendicular parking exercise, we had to repeat it a whole bunch of times because the system almost would hit an obstacle, like a motorcycle that was parked in a space or a big metal pylon. So you are always in control of the brakes and gas, and you really need to be because sometimes the computer wants to navigate you into some place where you really shouldn't be. The Edge is a really big car, so it's nice that it has obstacle sensors that let you know if you're gonna hit something. They're all around the car, and they come in really handy during perpendicular parking when you're not quite sure if the computer is gonna back you up into another car. The center console gives you visual cues of where everything's at, and you also get audio alerts to let you know you're getting closer to that immovable object. This is the kind of system that really should be standard in all cars, because even if it's a low speed tap, you can still do really serious body or paint damage. So here's another smart feature that every modern car should have. A front-mounted 180-degree camera that can peek around corners to see pedestrians. The basic view lets you see what's up front, hit the button again, and you get a full 180-degree view. and it'll let you see things that you wouldn't otherwise be able to view from the driver's seat. So it could be a shopping cart, could be a little kid. It lets you peek around corners and get the full scope of what's happening around you. So that's Ford's high-tech safety story. Do I want it? Yeah, everything except the automatic parking assist. Do I want you to have it? Yes, most definitely, because I don't trust your driving and I want you to stay away from me on the open road.